What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Rhett and Evan from the Cannon Fire Podcast back today with another video about the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So we are going to try and make the best sense that we can about the Antonio Brown situation that happened yesterday on the road against the Jets. So from what we understand, the most up-to-date situation that we have heard, obviously Antonio Brown being released by the Buccaneers, no longer a member of the team.
He is no longer a Buck. All right, that's the end of the story. Let's talk about the guys that went out there and won the game.
He did not fly back with the rest of the team after Bruce Arians confirmed in his post-game press conference that AB is no longer a Buccaneer. And the story has come out through a series of updates that basically Bruce Arians talked to Antonio Brown on the sidelines and tried to get him to go back into the game. Antonio Brown refused. Bruce talked to him again. AB refused yet again, and BA told him to just get out of here, and that's exactly what we did. We saw it play out on live television. Antonio Brown took off his pads, took off his shirt, threw his gloves into the crowd, ran into the locker room, and that is probably going to be the last time we ever see him suited up as a Tampa Bay Buccaneer. But through a series of updates, we have got the latest. I believe the source was Jay Glazer on this one. Evan, what have you heard?
Yeah, so Glazer tweeted this out yesterday, shortly after the game. He talked to Bruce Arians. Did not want to talk about it in the press conference. Understandably, he didn't want to talk about it in the press conference, but he confirmed a lot of what you just said, that basically he tried to get Antonio Brown just going to the game. We don't know what it was for. If there's a conversation beforehand, we don't know, right? But what we do know, he tried to get Antonio Brown to go in the game. He refused. He tried it again. He refused. So then Jay Glazer asked Bruce Arians if he had seen Antonio Brown take his jersey off. And Bruce Arians says, yeah, I did. I've never seen anything like it in all my years. So this is the first time, really. Bruce Arians has been coaching football for a long time. This is the first time he's seen a guy do that. And really, it's the first time I've seen it, too. We talked about yesterday how Chris Myers thought it was a fan. And a lot of people thought, we were talking before the show we did yesterday. You thought it was a fan. A lot of people thought it was a fan. It turns out it's the wide receiver on your football team. And obviously, he's not a member of the Buccaneers anymore. You said probably won't be. Definitely won't be. This may be it for him in the NFL. Is another team really going to take a chance on him? It felt like this was it for him. And I think he threw it all away. He may have just thrown his entire NFL career away. He may have thrown the Hall of Fame away. But at this point, if you're going to do that, I don't really think you care much about that anyway, if you're going to do something like that. So, Antonio Brown, I think, has struggled with mental health issues. So, yes, this is not just him being a complete moron. I don't think. I truly don't. I think, some of it does have to do with some mental health stuff, while also, it doesn't excuse what he did, right? It doesn't excuse walking out on your teammates, especially after, walking out on the Buccaneers, after the Buccaneers had your back through the whole vaccination thing. It doesn't excuse that, but it also reminds us to check in on those people and make sure that they're doing okay, and that, mental health, it's a real issue, but at the same time, it doesn't excuse certain acts like Antonio Brown did. And now, he's going to face the consequences for it. He now doesn't have a job, and he just cost himself a lot of money because he could have had some bonuses, and he cost himself his career, really.
Yeah, you said it perfectly. And I think at the end of the day, the most important thing about this is, when you're talking about the situation from beyond a football level, I think what's important is getting a guy like Antonio Brown the help that he needs, because, as you said, I think this goes farther beyond, his notorious personality that people have come to know him for, and maybe the situation that's going on with him in Tampa Bay. What's important is that he can find the help that he needs off the field, because clearly there is just something going on there. But, no doubt this is going to be the biggest story of the week, so we just wanted to put out a video on top of it and basically cover it from beginning to end, because that's where we're going to leave it. Antonio Brown no longer a Tampa Bay Buccaneer, and this Bucs team is going to have to find a way to win without him moving forward, which is exactly what they were able to do in the second half of Sunday's game against the Jets. But the playoffs are getting ready to start. You're hoping for some of these guys on your offense to get healthy, and they're going to have to go out there without Antonio Brown. But that's just about going to do it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for checking it out. Subscribe to the channel for more Buccaneers content. Every day uploads, we're going to be coming at you, as well as the podcast a couple of times a week. We'll have our weekly mailbag as well coming up on Wednesday. So if you want to send in any takes or questions for that, our line is always open, cannonfirepodcast@gmail.com. And you can also find us on social media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. All of those are Cannon Fire Podcast. I am Rhett, signing off for Evan. We'll catch you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching. Until then, and as always, go Bucks.
Tampa Bay Buccaneers from the 48-yard line. Second down, 13. Brady lobs one downfield. Caught ball by Gronkowski.